Really glad that you're available to come to the library. Yeah, you're the only one who showed up. Everyone else is busy celebrating and partying because it's the end of college. Besides the fact we still have that last assignment to do. Yeah, I'll admit I'm not much of a partier. I'd much rather just get this assignment done and, then when, we get the get-go to send it in, I can have it sent in and be like, okay, all I need to wait is for it to be marked and then I know I'm completely done for sure. Is that weird? Then again, you turned up, so I guess you had the same idea. Get the work done, less to worry about. I see you didn't bring a laptop. Don't worry, I've got mine set up here anyway. Hold on, let me just put my notebook over here. And I'll just log into my account. Then we can see what the final assessment is. Yeah, I quite like being able to physically write out my work and then type it up. I don't know why, but it helps me study and, learn more. Think it's maybe because, I'm like physically doing something. I know that typing is also physically doing something, but there's just something about writing stuff out that helps me memorize it more. I'm not sure why. Right, let me just log in here. Must be for the extra studies. ICT, English, and all that, that we had to do like mini classes of to prove that we could, do basic stuff. Yeah, those were really dumb. You know what I mean? But I get why they get us, doing them to double check that we are qualified to at least be able to do the course. So, create a personal statement which outlines the journey you've traveled, highlights recognition of your strengths, considers areas for development, and states clearly what changes you are going to put in place as you embark on your next learning journey. Talk about a load of crap, huh? Don't get me wrong, I've enjoyed course we've been doing, but I think they're kind of up themselves while they're whoever wrote this clearly thought, we were gonna care a lot about this, but yeah, let's just get this over with. I mean, as a bonus, there's no word count, no word limit, so that's a good thing. The same time, jeez, outlines the journey you have traveled. All right, I think our best way of doing this is to look for the 4 points and write many notes about them before writing out any sort of personal statement, reflection piece. Jeez. Alright, so point one. Oh, this pen's a little dry. Let me use this pencil instead. Okay, so point. That's a bit better. Okay. Outline the journey you have traveled. I'm sorry. It just makes it sound like we've been on some sort of quest. You know, on an actual journey. What even would the journey be? Well, I guess. Okay. So one. Okay. Outline the journey. Okay, so our journey would be applying first week end of term one, term two, and like those 5 would work. Kind of. I mean, I think those are the ones I'm gonna go for, probably. Okay, so point two was highlight recognition of your strengths. I hate questions like these. Oh, I really, really do. Everyone else, you don't want to toot your own horn and say that you're great at one thing, and then you come unsure, and then you don't know if you are good at that thing or not. Let's see, what are some strengths? In course work on time, studying, teamwork. Yeah, I know, I was really quiet this year. When I needed to do teamwork, I did it. You were really good at teamwork, though. Oh, you were really good. I mean it. For real. We can add more to that later. Okay, free. Excuse me. Consider areas for development. Clearly what changes you're going to put in place as you embark on your Oof. Well, I guess you'd link that to your areas of development that you'd like to work on, so. Pardon me again. Oh, I'm all right. I just didn't sleep great last night. Oh, nothing really. I just was stressing out about that final test we took last week, and the results are coming out, you know, 1 a.m. today. Stressed out in case I hadn't passed and I need to resit it. I ended up staying up and then my internet went down, so I didn't go back on till 4, and at that point I couldn't sleep anyway, so when I soon passed, I ended up you know, tidying up my study booklets and, you know, getting stuff ready for studying over summer for the next part of the course. Yeah, of course I study over summer. Don't you? You don't? Then how are you prepared for the next part of the course? Come on, prepared. Wow, that's, that seems really risky. Hey, what are you doing? I can't go for a nap in here. It's library. It's not meant for naps. It's meant for studying and chilling out with a good book. So, can you please give me back my pencil? Please? Come on, don't take my book as well, please. Please don't, I'm too tired for this carry-on. What? You'll give it back if I promise to go back to my dorm and go for a nap. You won't give it back until tomorrow. But it's the weekend and
just
stay up a little longer and just get it done. All right, fine. I'll go to bed, but if I don't go to bed early, then you've got to go to your bed early. No partying or anything tonight. Yeah, I know it's a Friday night, but you should see the bags under your eyes. Alright then. No more studying for today. But I better see you bright and early so we can get this done. I mean it. All right, then. I'll see you tomorrow.